Hey guys, welcome, welcome, welcome to my channel. This is the Encourager Queen C, No Longer Bound. Thank you, thank you, thank you for clicking. Thank you for coming in. I appreciate you so much. Guys, if you're new here, make sure that you like, you share, and subscribe this video. And then if you're coming back, thank you for coming back. Thank you for supporting. I appreciate all that you do. Today's video, we are talking about high blood pressure in Black people, in the Black community. Now, we know it's spread abroad, but tonight we're going to be specific, and we're talking about in the Black community. And for our source, we're going to be using verywellhealth.com and some other research areas in helping us out. Now, for my disclaimer, I am a certified hemodialysis technician, and I work in turn with high blood pressures and just dealing in the medical field on a daily basis. That's what I do. So we want to talk about high blood pressure. And guys, we just did one on osteoporosis. Make sure you check that video out. That is the one that we did, I believe, yesterday. And what are we doing on this series? It is focusing on good health, focusing on good health. And we'll be choosing various topics to do. So by all means, you know, anything that I talk about that you have a question about, you need me to do more research on, or you like it, or you didn't like it, or you're dealing with it, or you have a comment that can help somebody else, there's something you do that works for you and helps you to lower your blood pressure or whatever the case may be, by all means, please share that. We need that information. We're a community. We're a family. Listen, the encourager, that's what we do. We encourage other people. We encourage each other. And we build each other up. And we all want to have good health. Is that right? So I got my trusty peddler here. We're going to be doing some exercise. Yeah. And working on building up the heart muscles a little bit. And as we also, with my computer over here, we're going to talk about, give some information. So first things first, this is a blood pressure cuff. And I know you probably already have one at home. You know, I have mine. I won't pop it loose because I have it fit just right for my arm. So when you're by yourself and you need to do your blood pressure, so what I can do this first thing in the morning, I take it like twice a day in the morning, and then I take it in the evening. That'll be, can be before I go to bed or something like that. In the morning, you want to take it maybe when you first get up, but you want to not be running around before you take it. So you want to kind of be able to settle down, you know, at least have a few minutes of quiet time. And then you can take it so that you don't get a false reading or something. And I just slide it right on my arm like that. Now, if you notice, this is where my arm bends. And if you would ever take your time and just take a, put your fingers right there, if you can see it, this arm bend on the inside of my arm, right there. Yeah. And you can feel a pulse. You'll feel that pulsating. Yeah. Okay, so you kind of want this line, this cuff, and some of them, you see that arrow? Let me get closer. See that arrow, right? I don't know if you can see it. On your cuff, there's an arrow, and it'll say right there, right in there, right? Line up with your index finger right in there, like that, okay? And you put that there and you know you're in a good position. Some people put it behind them and all around them. It still works. It still works. But that's why they put that there. They kind of want it to. If you just, and you see the arm demonstration here, and they have it inside the cuff to show you. You also want to make sure that you get a cuff that is not too large or too small. Because if it's too large, it's going to give a false reading. And if it's too large, it's going to give a false reading. So they usually come like regular, and we have large, and then we have small. Because some people, it's small, it's almost the size to go to your wrist. Some people have very slender arms. And this one would be just way too big. It would be too big. So they have one that's the size of the wrist, and even though it's a wrist cuff, it might fit up here on that person because their arm is just so tiny, you know, and you don't want something that's going to wrap around two or three times and you're not going to get a good reading. So I also have the, I'm sure you probably have this one out. No matter what brand, this is Blue Jay. And it's called Blue Jay. And it has batteries in the back. Yeah, I think it's 3A batteries or whatever, two sets back there. Batteries in the back. And it also has a plug that you can plug it in. There's an electrical outlet right there. You can plug it in to charge it as well. I like the batteries because I don't have to be worrying about it. I just keep them charged up. And yeah, that way I can, they're ready to go. They're ready to go. Guys, I'm trying to make sure my mic is out again so you can hear me clearly. Yeah, they're ready to go. So you have your systolic, and you have your diastolic, and you have your pulse. Now, your pulse is your heart rate, how fast it's beating. And you'll notice when you go to the doctor sometime, they'll feel right there at your wrist, and they'll feel your pulse, okay? And you can take it in various different places, here and there and in the thigh, wherever you need it. We know those points that we can get it. The most common is probably the wrist. They'll walk up to you and do your wrist, and if not, the inner arm right there. Okay, so this is very self-contained. Now, at work, you know, we have the stethoscope, and we have the old traditional way. So if you're good at it, and I don't have my scope over here now, but if you're good at it, you can put your stethoscope in and go ahead and plant it here, you see. But the hard part of it is going to be that if you're manually pumping it up with the manual pump and you're trying to hear it, it's going to be it's too difficult. So they made these, and they're very, very easy to use. So you want to, it'll give you instructions how to sit, you know, flat, your feet flat on the floor. And you want to be relaxed. And then all you need to do is just push the start button. Hear that little beep. And then you give it a couple of minutes. It'll just pump right up. Yeah, it'll pump right up just like that. And you wait for it. Very good, very good. So now you're going to get and I won't show it to you as personal, but you're going to get a double reading on top here, okay? You're going to get your systolic reading, you're going to get your diastolic reading, and you're going to get your pulse rate. It'll tell you what that is right there. Now, we're going to talk about some numbers, and get this off here. Okay, put that over there. All right, and so we're going to talk about a couple of things. And exercise is definitely one that you want to do. So we're going to make sure that we do some exercising. So why exercise? Exercise helped to get the heart rate up. Yeah, I thought you said, well, I thought you want to lower your blood pressure. Yeah, but you want to get your heart rate up so it can begin to pump through those vessels and pump some oxygen out to all your extremities. Yeah, you want to get it up. You just don't want your heart rate up all the time. And if it's up all the time, now that's called something else, and you got a problem there. So you don't want that. But you want to get your heart rate up, yeah. And then you relax and let it, you know, settle down again. But you need to do this continuously. You need to at least do something every day to try to get your heart rate pumping like an athlete, you know, get you running out there. If you're not able to run, you're not able to walk no more, you can do some aerobic. This is kind of like an aerobic exercise because it's making me put pressure to push the pedal. Yeah, and it also has, I told you, I think I showed you once before, a new audience, so I won't assume This is a petal. I'm gonna hold it up so you can see it, like so. You've seen them in the stores, I'm sure. Yeah, and you can do this on the table, put it down for your feet on the floor. And in the back of it, here's a knob. This is a knob, a tension knob. So I can turn this and I can loosen it or make it tighter. Yeah, so if I make it tighter, then that makes it harder for me to push. Now I loosened it, so that's gonna make me go faster, and I can go at a faster rate, and I can raise my heart rate up. Okay, can you still hear me? Yeah, raise my heart rate up with that, see? Yeah, and that way I can push the blood through those veins and those vessels and get some oxygenated blood out to my extremities and where they're supposed to go. Yeah, so that's what a good walk would do for you. Or, yeah, or people that jog, they jog. I don't jog, I walk. And did a bummer on my knee years and years ago, so jogging doesn't seem to work for me too well. So you don't want to do anything that's going to cause you bodily harm, okay? Bodily harm. If you do too much and you get too stiff, or you pull a muscle or something, then you're not going to be able to continuously exercise. And so you're going to be defeating your purpose if you do that, right? Okay, so we want to do these guys right here. Do a few more of these, then we're going to get some statistics out. And another thing is drinking water. You want to make sure that you have water in your system. Now, sometimes I have to remind myself, because we should drink at least 1 to 2 liters of water a day. We should drink at least 1 to 2. And sometimes I forget, so I have to come home and chug a lug. And another thing too, so it depends on the job that you do. Sometimes when I'm at work, if I'm drinking a lot, then I'm running to the facilities a lot. So I gotta make sure that I try to pace it, yeah, because I can't continuously do my work if I'm forever running to the facilities. So what I try to do sometimes is, as soon as I see that I only have maybe a couple of more hours before time for me to get off work, I'll start really pouring in the water. I'll start trying to really get the water in, because I know then that I'll have access and I'll be able to go to the facilities, yeah, to empty my bladder, do what I need to do. Yeah, so water is another way of helping us maintain our blood pressure. And we're gonna talk also about diet. There's a lot of factors. Some things we can't change as Black people, no person at all, but because we're talking about this because of the risk, and we'll give some numbers in a minute on how the high blood pressure is pertaining to the Black population. I know you hear that all the time, all the time, all the time. So we wanna throw out some numbers on that. And I'll see if we come up with some measures on how we can help ourselves. We just don't want to always hear the figures and ignore the figures and say, oh, you know, whatever, because it's kind of easy to do. You get so sick of hearing it over and over and over. You know, I mean, my goodness, you're just like, wow. Every time I turn around, it's just Black people and high blood pressure, diabetes, blah, 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 you name it, name it, name it. So we have to work on that. And stress levels, we're going to find out that stress can run your pressure up. And if you're living under continuous stress, and many of us do, I mean, just our race alone can cause us stress. Yeah, yeah, I mean, let's just be real. This is life. I mean, you know something, there's something about this with hypertension. We as a people, if we pretend that something doesn't exist, it's not helping us get any better. We have to be able to realize that we have to face it, and we have to figure out what we can do. How can we manage it? What can we do? Some things we can't change. We're never going to be able to change the melanin in our skin. So we gotta live with that. And we are never gonna be able to change everybody's mind as far as prejudices are concerned and those type of things. That's not gonna happen. So we have to find a way to not allow it to affect our health, to not allow it to bring undue stress, because that's one of the things that can cause hypertension. So we don't want to have undue stress going on. So whereas we got that stress on the job, stress in school, the kids have stress, you know, it's just stress, stress, stress. Now stress is not always bad, but when you're under continuous stress pertaining to something like that, it affects your health. And hypertension can lead to other things, right? It can lead to diabetes. It can lead to all kinds of different other diseases. And the thing about it is, it's called the silent killer. And the reason it's called the silent killer is because it doesn't have symptoms. You know, like we just dealt with COVID, there were some symptoms. You get the flu, there's some symptoms. Just a plain cold, there's some symptoms. Arthritis, anything, there's symptoms, but high blood pressure is a silent killer. There are no symptoms. And you can think that you'll be okay, and you start checking your pressure, and you'll find out, like, wow, I'm 140, I'm 150, I'm 160, I'm 170. Systolic, talk about the top number. Yeah, that can be something else. That's how much pressure is taking for your heart that we're working on right now to pump that blood through those arteries. Yeah, to pump that blood out. And why? Because they could be clogged up with something. Yeah, something is keeping them clogged, and there's not as much room inside those arteries as there should be. And that comes through over time, and a lot of hard calcification build up inside. And now, you know, the blood is having trouble getting through. So it could be something, stress is a factor, something we eat, hereditary can be a factor. There's a lot of things that could be a factor. So what can we do? So the things that we can't change, we're going to have to leave that up to God. We can't do anything about that part. But the things that we can change, that's what we want to work on. So we can exercise. We can eat properly. We can drink our amount of water. We can take our blood pressure, if not every day, we can take it on a regular basis to see where we are. We can cut back on our salt, and we can, there's things that we can do. We can cut back on eating so much just high fat foods and things of that sort. There's things that we can do. And of course, we can get assistance from the doctor for medication. Now, if you're like me, even though I take a mild medication, my continuous goal is to not have to take a mild medication. I don't want to have to take any medication. Now, I don't know if that'll ever happen, but that's my goal to do that. So my goal is trying to maintain and regulate my weight and lose a few pounds if I can, keep exercising. Yeah, keep the heart pumping and keep that blood pumping out there. Yeah, yeah, just doing those type of things. So we're going to stop here for a couple of minutes, and we're going to go in and get some facts, and then we'll come back and see what we can do here. All right, so let's go over here. Now, one of the things that I have, get my computer back up here. Let's see what we're saying. Let's push this over a little bit, bring it over so we can read some facts here. So, all right, so got my tablet, my laptop over here, guys, and we're looking at high blood pressure. So it's like, why high blood pressure is a risk factor for heart disease? Why is it a risk factor for heart disease? And we're going to, even before we go there, let's say high blood pressure and heart disease risk in black people. High blood pressure, heart disease risk in black people. That's where we wanted to go. And let's see here. Okay, so it says disparities in housing, employment, healthcare have contributed to poor health in racial and ethnic minority communities. This can increase the likelihood of developing hypertension or high blood pressure, which can then increase the risk of heart disease. You know, I mean, our body is a unit, it goes together. Even more historically marginalized groups like black people have a harder time accessing high quality medical care when they need it, and that can cause stress. You know, we're coming into Black History Month, so you're gonna be able to understand all through history we've had issues with just getting proper health care, no matter, you know, where we are. It doesn't even matter how much money you make. I mean, Dr. Charles Drew, he was the founder of the blood bank, and when he needed care, there was a problem. You see what I'm trying to say? So what do you think about that? Okay, so we go here, it says, okay, so quality medical care when they need it, underscoring the importance of preventing chronic diseases such as hypertension before they begin. So, how blood pressure equals increased heart disease. High blood pressure equals increased heart disease, So, high blood pressure, heart disease. Wow, and other things too, but now let's just go there. Black people are 40% more likely to have high blood pressure, which increases their risk of heart disease. We're 40% more likely, okay? And these numbers are coming from the CDC, I think. And also, like I said, we're doing Dr. Zoe Henson on Very Well Health here. High blood pressure can thicken the arteries. Now, remember I said that when I was doing this exercise here, and I'm making a heart pump, move all these cords I got here, making a heart pump harder. So I'm trying to get it to pump like a pitcher pump. I want it to pump some blood out there, pump it out there. I'm trying to get it to pump it out there in my arteries. It's got to go all the way to my toes. It's got to go to my fingertips. It's got to go all the way out there. That oxygenated, it's got to go. It's got to go. It's got to go, right? Okay, so high blood pressure can thicken arteries, causing undue stress on the heart and blood vessels. So if the pressure, the systolic pressure is high, above 120, 130, yeah, if it's high, the higher it is, it says here, it's causing undue stress now on the heart and pushing that blood vessel and pushing that blood out there. So over time, the heart must work harder and harder to overcome this pressure until it eventually gives out. So it's up there and it's got to really push. It's got to really push. It's like a steam engine. I guess this pressure is getting higher and higher and higher, you know, trying to push it through that steam line there, right? Okay. So what is causing high blood pressure? So we got some water here. Remember I said I hit my water in? And we also have a banana here, which is for potassium. We're gonna eat that. Okay, so it says here, what is considered high blood pressure? What is considered high blood pressure? Blood pressure consistently above 130. The top systolic number, the high number on your reader, the systolic one up here, if it's consistently above 130, okay? And this one down here is usually around 80, and that's not bad, but it's this one, that systolic one. So if it's consistently above 130, okay, over 80, it is considered high. Now, let me just keep reading for a minute here, okay? So race, so I said this was about Black people and high blood pressure, this particular segment, okay, on Focus on Good Health. Is on Black people and high blood pressure. So let's say, according to a 2018 study in the Journal of the American Heart Association, 75.5% of Black men, 75.7% of Black women who participated in this study went on to develop high blood pressure by the age of 55 years. This is compared to 54.5% of white men and 40% of white women. Okay, they're always going to compare the two groups, you know, for the reason. High blood pressure is one of the most common causes of heart disease in the Black community. And this is what we want to fix. We want to change this. We want to turn this around. Somebody say, turn it around. Turn it around. We want to turn it around. Okay. Still, these numbers are likely an underestimation due to the lack of access to care. So we're probably not getting a good count here. It says, and some reluctant to seek care even when it's available, because some people just, I'm one, I don't like to go to the doctor. I go. You see, I got all my stuff here that I take blood pressure and do all that. But I'm not one that loves to be in the doctor's office. That's why you always see me, you know, you're going to see me doing some of this. I'm working it, you know, trying to keep myself in good shape. I'm walking out in the trails and doing mall walkings and, on a daily basis, I'm doing that. Yeah. Working that. Why? Because I'm not somebody that just love to be, every time you turn around, I'm in the doctor's office. Now you say, but wait a minute, you work there. You work in medicine. You've been working in medicine just about all your life. I know. Working in it and being the one that's being treated is a whole different ballgame. I'm telling you, it's a whole different ballgame. And my focus is good health. So I'm working there to try to help other people maintain their health and good health, but I'm not the one that want to be there. That's the way that goes. That's not where I want to be. All right, so let's go on. Okay, so I think I just lost something here. Okay, we're good. All right, so low socioeconomic status and lower health literacy rates, the degree that people have the capacity to obtain, process, and understand health information. So a lot of people just don't fully understand it. And like I say, if there are no symptoms, you say, I feel fine. Because that happened to me when I was caring for my family, my husband and my mom. So I was so caught up in making sure that they had care. And I was so caught up in making sure they got all their meds, making sure that they got all their appointments met, making sure that they had their surgeries done, making sure that they had all the equipment that they need and everything. So I wasn't really, I was not taking my pressure, and I definitely wasn't taking it regularly because I was feeling fine. And I was just feeling fine. And I thought, you know, hey, I'm okay. My focus is on them right now. I just got to get them. I'm okay. And so one day, thank God for the body being made in a way that it helps us to, it wants to heal itself. So one day, I woke up and I had a bloodshot eye. And I'm like, wow, I never have a bloodshot eye. What is going on? And so I just went to get that checked out. Wasn't really looking for blood pressure, just get my bloodshot eye checked out. And because I thought I had rubbed it or had done something that night during the sleep, I wasn't sure. So when I get to the eye doctor, and he looked at it and he said, but do you know that your blood pressure is high? I think at that time it was 180, my top number. My top number here, it's like 180 over something. And I said, oh no. I said, I'm always low blood pressure. That can't be. But see, I didn't realize how much stress I had been under and what I had been doing. And I probably was eating on the fly, probably wasn't eating properly, getting my fruits and vegetables in, just grabbing something, could have been eating processed food. I know I was probably drinking pops and just doing things, just grabbing and going and grabbing and going. Not resting, definitely wasn't getting proper rest. Now, I have to admit it, I was not. Because why? I was taking care of a couple of people. So I'm like, you know, working double jobs, right? On the same shift, I'm working double jobs. So I'm laying down, catnapping, whatever, but I wasn't getting sleep. So all of a sudden my pressure is way up. So my doctor goes, whoa, we gotta do something. So that's how I ended up being on a mild blood pressure medication. And so now that we are got it under control, we're doing good. My goal now is to get completely off of that particular medication. So we're saying here then, high blood pressure not only damages the heart, did we skip something? Let's see here. Let's go back, and I don't want to skip. High blood pressure levels over a long period of time can thicken your heart muscle and blood vessels, changing the structure and the function of these tissues and putting you at risk for heart failure. So high blood pressure not only damages the heart, but may also affect other organs of the body, like the kidneys. Now, I told you I work in dialysis, and that is huge. And there's many, many people that, you know, one of the reasons they're on dialysis is because of high blood pressure. Now, we know other things go on, diabetes is second cause and things like that, but we're right now, tonight, we're talking about high blood pressure. So it says here, can affect other organs of the body, like the kidneys, the brain, liver, okay, and the liver, and putting even more stress on the body and further exacerbating, worsening your high blood pressure, making it even worse, okay? So even at chronically high levels, high blood pressure can show little or no symptoms. So even at my 180 at that time, there was no symptoms. I told you I felt fine. I felt fine, okay? You see, which is why it is often referred to as what? The silent killer. The silent killer. It is killing you silently. So, guys, I'm telling you, let's get a drink of water here. I want to eat my banana or do it. Okay, so, in fact, some people are unaware that they have high blood pressure and only find out that it's too late. It says, let me read it again. In fact, some people are unaware that they have high blood pressure and only find out when it's too late. This underlines the importance of, we say, prevention, 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 and what early detection and initiating prompt treatment. Prevention, prevention, prevention. This is one form of prevention right here. Is exercise, exercise. And you know, we say that sometimes. I have a lot of folks, they'll look at you like, really? I ain't doing no exercise. I'm not gonna do this. I'm not gonna walk. I'm not gonna run. I'm not gonna do a peddler. I'm not gonna do whatever the case may be. And that's okay. Do you know that you don't have to? The Bible says, yes, 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 I'm a Bible teacher. The Bible says that we are workers together with Christ. Workers together with Christ, right? So we want to be healed. We want to be, I do, be in good health. But I need to do my part to help me to be in good health. I can't just sit and simply say, God, make sure everything goes right with my body, and I don't do any exercise. I don't eat right. I don't get proper rest. I'm always stressed out. I'm always at 100. And yet, I'm wondering then, God, why aren't you doing what you're doing? And he's saying, whoa, I believe the Lord is saying, I'm doing my part. We're workers together in this thing, right? Right? Yeah. Okay, let's get some more. So underlying cause, oh, and I'm feeling that too. Underlying cause of high blood pressure disparities. Let's see what we're saying here. Okay, the cause of ethnic and racial inequalities that give rise to high blood pressure disparities are complex. Okay, so it says prevalence of high blood pressure in black people. Black people are 40% more likely to have high blood pressure than white folks. We've already established that. Factors that likely contribute to such a disparity in high blood pressure for black people include, okay, so substandard insurance coverage. So if we don't have proper insurance, we're not gonna get proper care. Mm-hmm. That's a fact. Poor access to health care, lower rates of health literacy, socioeconomic status, okay. Additionally, evidence suggests that the longer immigrants of any race live in the United States, the more likely they are to develop high blood pressure. That the longer immigrants of any race live in the United States, that might be saying something to us right there. Shit. I did not know that part. Excuse me, that's funny. I mean, it's not funny, but it's funny. I did not know that part. I gotta read that again. Additionally, Evidence suggests that the longer immigrants of any race live in the United States, the more likely they are to develop high blood pressure. That's not good. They're saying the United States will make you sick. Oh my, 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 my. Wow, it says here, let me see if there's something else on this. Later residence in the United States is associated with a higher prevalence of cardiometabolic risk factors in immigrants. A contemporary analysis of the National Health Interview Survey. Wow. 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 That's, guys, that's not good. Living in the United States can make you sick. All right. I didn't write this. That's what this study says. Okay, let's move on because of time. See, one major culprit of high blood pressure that may explain this phenomenon is the adoption of the Southern diet. One that includes, and here we go, because I'm a Southerner, all the way, country gal. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. So, one that includes high intake of fried foods. Now, I grew up on eating fried food. Yes, I did. Boiled food, but also fried food. Most time I was a kid, I loved eating fried chicken. Still do occasionally, not as much now. I got an air fryer now, or I also got my crock pot I can boil and do things like that. But I definitely grew up on eating fried chicken, fried pork chop, fried whatever else that we had. I enjoyed it being fried. Got something that's tickling my nose, that's why I keep doing it. I enjoyed it being fried. It was nice and crunchy and brown and flavored, and put me some salt and pepper on it and something else there, and it was just good, and I enjoyed that. Yes, yes, yes. All right. Organ meats, okay. So what is that? My mom loved to eat liver, and in the Southern tier, we had, guys, I never cared for them because I was raised on the farm. But we had chitlins, hawk chitlins. I never cared for them. I saw my mom clean too many of them, and I didn't want anything to do with them. But, yeah, that's a big staple. People eat those, okay? Processed meats. You used to eat processed meats. That's your bologna and all of your cold cuts and your hot dogs and, you know, all of those guys. You know, it used to be nothing to grab a couple of hot dogs. But if you ever get a moment to, and I learned to read labels. I learned to read labels, guys. Once my husband was on dialysis, I learned to read labels. And if you ever take a moment when you're shopping, excuse me, and you look at a pack of hot dogs, for example, and just read on the back of it, how much sodium is it? Sodium is in that thing. One hot dog sometimes can have 400 milligrams of sodium. That's one. Now you tell me, how many people only eat one hot dog? I've never died. If even when I would buy hot dogs, if I was at a place that they were selling hot dogs, most time you're gonna buy one is gonna be fully dressed in a pop and some chips or something else, or you at home you're gonna eat two hot dogs or something. Very few. So if you're eating two, that's already 800 milligrams of sodium just in those two things. That's not counting the chips, and that's not counting what's in the pop, and that's not counting anything else. So right there, we've loaded ourselves up full of sodium already. I mean, we've really done it, right? Okay, so this just not telling you don't eat stuff, just saying be aware of it. We're saying being aware of it. What are we doing? We're trying to live longer, and we're trying to live healthier. That's what this is all about. That's the whole deal, okay? So now it says, processed meats, it says eggs, egg dishes, added fats, high-fat dairy foods, sugar, sweetener beverages, and bread. Now, I don't eat eggs like I used to, but I grew up with eggs. My mom raised chickens, so there was always eggs there. Yeah, fresh eggs anytime we wanted them, right? Yes, yes. Not only has this been identified as a key reason for the racial gap in high blood pressure, but it's also helped to explain the heart disease disparities that are seen among Black people who live in the South compared to other parts of the country. Now, I do want to say one thing. These reports now I'm seeing is coming out as later, because I want to tell you something. In the South, people, Black people, live long. My grandfather lived to be in his late 90s. My mom, even though I moved her up here, she lived to be 101. And if you go down there now, you'll still see there's some people that live very long. Now, back in years back, even though they ate these foods, all these foods that they're naming here, Black people exercise more. They exercise more. They farmed more. They worked hard. They worked more. So by them exercising and working more, that all of that stuff wasn't able to stay into their arteries. It didn't clog up into their arteries. They didn't have sit-down jobs, most of them. They didn't have, they were up from sun up to sun down. They were working. And so therefore, their bodies was getting great exercise all day long, doing something. Yeah. So they lived long. Nowadays, though, if we're eating the same basic diets, right, and we're sitting at the computer all day, or we have a driving job that we're sitting down all day, or just whatever we're doing, or we just decide again that we're not going to do any exercise whatsoever, and we're just going to chill in front of the TV all day, or if we're just going to be a couch potato, I don't know what it is. I just know that if we are not moving that blood through the system, and if we're not flushing those impurities out, I know that they're going to cake up inside, and I know that we're going to have some issues, we're going to have some problems, right? Okay. Let's move on to a little bit more. All right, so of note, gaps exist in the medication compliance. How well a person adheres to taking their prescriptions on time. So we gotta make sure we take the medicine on time, take the right dosage, and do anything that we can for antihypertensive therapies, okay? Let's see what else we need here now. So the link between stress, racism, and high blood pressure, we talked about that. Racism is a special kind of stress. Guys, even though we exercise, that's one way of getting rid of the stress. When you get aggravated, you get upset, you got to go to the gym, you got to go somewhere, you got to burn it off. Because otherwise, it'll stay inside and it's going to pump your pressure up. It's going to pump it up. I'm telling you. Listen, racism is a special kind of stress that impacts Black people in a myriad of ways, right? Including raising blood pressure. It affects us. It affects our youth. It affects the whole entire body. I don't know how you can say that when you deal with racism, it doesn't affect you. You're burning up inside, and you know you are. You got to find a way to express some kind of way to get that anger out. It will eat you alive. Repeated exposure to discrimination and systemic unfairness within the system, which is unfairness in the system, completely exposed to unfairness in the system, is associated with biological aging of the cells, a phenomenon called biological weathering, which leads to genetic changes that age and lower the functioning of the cells. So now, even though we are looking very young on the outside, like we say, Black don't crack, and we keep that, but our inner bodies can be aging. It can be aging and it can be dying. Why? Because of the stress and because of the discrimination. And you'll hear the politicians say, there is no discrimination, there's no racism, there's no this, there's no that. And you're living it every day, and it's eating at your gut inside, and you're dealing with it, whether it's where you live, or it's where you drive, or it's where you, wherever it is, it's there. You got to deal with it. And it's bothering your health. It's bothering your high blood pressure, okay? Other factors. The following lifestyle choices and behaviors increase your risk of being diagnosed with high blood pressure. So eating an unhealthy diet. Guys, one of the things that we can eat right here, and we've been teased about it for years, is a banana. Mm-hmm. Yes. Potassium. And if you're not on kidney failure yet, potassium helps to lower your blood pressure. Eating an unhealthy diet. This is especially true for diets high in sodium. We gotta find a way to cut back on the salt. Gotta find a way. Guys, even at restaurants, when you're eating at restaurants and things of this sort, and you're buying the food, they've already prepared it. It might taste great, but sometimes they can be really high in salt. So what I do, even when I'm looking for my soups, I like a certain brand of soup, I'll look for low sodium soup. Yes, I'll read on the back. And some stores now, in the health department, they're starting to put labels on them, and it'll say low sodium. Yeah, and you can learn to eat that. You can learn. Okay, sugar. I thank God I have been able to, I told you, I do not do added sugar. I do not do added sugar. No. I stopped buying sugar years ago. Thank God for that. Yeah. I do not, excuse me for shaking the camera. I do not do added sugar. How did I stop it? I just made up my mind, first of all, that I just needed to cut back. And the number one thing that caused me to stop it was I bought that pop. And when I bought that pop, and I was beginning to read on the back of that pop, and that can, that one 12-ounce can of pop had over 35, I think, milligrams of sugar in it. And I thought, wow, I haven't even had a dessert. I haven't even had anything else. And mostly everything you buy, and when you read the label, you're going to see that it has added sugar in it. Things that you don't even think that have sugar has sugar in it. So if that's already in there, and then you turn around and buy more sugar and you dunk it in, you're getting over an abundance. And sugar depletes the vitamins. Then we'll talk about that one day. Sugar takes the vitamins away out of the bloodstream, okay? It's anti-nutrient. All right. And saturated fats. Okay, so let's look at physical inactivity. We talked about that. The COVID-19 pandemic, the globalization of work schedules, and the digital shift that has taken place is almost in almost every industry have contributed greatly to the new norm of living a sedentary lifestyle. So we didn't have to go to work, you didn't have to go to church. You didn't have to go to school. You didn't have to go anywhere. So you just kind of sat and worked on your computer, and now things are starting to kick up inside and settle. The body needs regular physical activity to keep the heart and blood vessels strong and healthy. Regular. In fact, regular exercise lower blood pressure. Whoa, regular exercise does what? Lower blood pressure. Regular exercise lower blood pressure. All right. Without it, you are at a higher risk of hypertension. Wow, guys, we're running out of time on this. Obesity, we already know, is associated with high load density, the lipoprotein, the LDL, easy to say, which is the bad cholesterol levels, and the high density HDL, the good cholesterol. So levels in arteriosclerosis, which is atherosclerosis, is build up of fats. It's build up of fats, cholesterol, and other substances in the walls of the arteries. Together, these conditions and the stress to the heart and the surrounding blood vessels. Okay, so we don't want to be overweight. If we can find a way to lose, I'm still need to get off about 10, 15 pounds. I'd be glad to do that. Even though people say you don't look like it, you don't look like it. It's not about that. A lot of times, fat is on the inside. It's internal. It's around the organs. It's around the organs inside. It's not so much that you see it on the outside as a person walking, you see that, but it can be internal fat, and that is not a good fat. That's a terrible one. That is when it's inside, tangle around your organs and everything. That's not good. Okay. Okay. Excessive alcohol intake. I pray that no one is doing that one. Do I need to read that? Alcohol may directly contribute to raising one's blood pressure. Alcohol can raise your blood pressure. Generally, men have more wiggle room than women because of their body structure or whatever in the case may be. All right. In the development, but generally, the less alcohol you drink, the better it is for your heart. The less alcohol you drink, the better it is for your heart. Well, thank God I was delivered from that, so I don't have that problem. And I pray that you don't either. Smoking. You already know. Excuse me. The cancer-causing agents, the carcinogens in the cigarette smoke damage the heart and blood vessels. And it's not so much that you smoke, but also secondhand smoke can be definitely. I think there's a study that says secondhand smoke is even worse than you actual smoking, I believe. So we don't want to be doing that. And we've already talked about stress. Again, as we come to a close, stress can temporarily raise blood pressure. Chronic stress can cause the body, chronic stress can change the body in such a way that the body continues to keep blood pressure high well after the acute stressor is gone. So chronic is long-term. So whatever that caused you to get all build up, you know, the stress in the first place, after a while that thing is gone, but you still gives your blood pressure up. A normal blood pressure for an adult is less than 120 over 80. And this means that the top number called the systolic, which we talked about earlier, remember I showed you the top number up there where it read on your thing, okay? Called the systolic pressure averages less than 120, and the bottom number, which is the diastolic, this one here, okay, averages less than what we say 80. If your systolic pressure is between 120 and 129, or your diastolic is higher than 80, you're at risk of developing stage one or stage two. Okay? And many of us are there. Now, they found out that in mature adults, the older you get, your blood pressure have a tendency to raise. So some of your doctors now will say, we want you below 130. Okay? Even though 120 over 80, but we want you below 130. So if you can be below 130, that's a good thing as well. According to the new blood pressure guidelines put forth by the American Heart Association, stage one, hypertension means that the systolic blood pressure is between 130, this is the new one I was just telling you about, and 139, or your diastolic blood pressure is between 80 and 90. Stage two hypertension means that your systolic pressure is higher than 140, and or your diastolic pressure is higher than 90, okay? So, and into integrative treatment approach, let's see here. We're not going to go there because of time. It says high blood pressure is something you can treat. Below are treatment options for high blood pressure that you can discuss with your healthcare provider. So we're going to talk about, if you're interested in finding out some things, maybe for lifestyle changes, you know, let me know, leave a comment or something, and maybe we can talk about that. We can talk about how we can eat heart healthy, yeah, and maintain healthy weight, and some ways that we can find to exercise regularly, and how much sleep we should get, and do things of that sort. We can even talk about stress management, some ways that we can work on managing stress. So if this is something that, you know, you think that really interests you, and you like to leave a comment, and if you think so, then we'll talk about it, right, guys? Yeah. So exercise, and I've got to finish and make sure I get some more revs in before the night is over with. Yeah, get my heart rate up. And guys, it's not just me telling you about it. This is something that I do. This is my life. Yeah. And this is what I do. This is my life. And I'm determined because I want to live healthy. Oh, yeah. And even when people retire, you know, you want to live healthy. You just don't want to. You know, if it's something you can't control, it's something you can't control. We're not talking about that. We're talking about things that we can do to help ourselves control this thing. I believe we can turn this thing around. We don't always have to be black people that are most prevalent to get high blood pressure and diabetes and all of these things. We can change this. We are strong people. We are healthy people. Man, we survive. We are people that survive. I mean, we've got a history of surviving. And we have a history of over-surviving, making it through. We can do this. how much pressure do we have that's trying to put us down? And we always seem to come up, right? We're like Maya Angelou say, still I rise, still I rise. So we're not caught up into this. We can turn this thing on. We're the best athletes. We're the best everything that we go to do. We are the top of the line for it. Yes, we are. And we can be the top of the line with our good health. Live long and strong in the Lord. Is that good? I like that one. We can live long and strong in the Lord. Amen. So guys, get you one of these peddlers, if you will. This one is a U10, U-T-E-N. But you can get anyone. You can get this on Amazon.com. But you can get these anywhere. Yeah. Yeah. And start doing some exercise. If you can't do nothing but sit down like I'm doing on the stool, and you put this thing on the table and just turn it, that'll work. Because I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it in my arms, feeling it in my waistline. Yeah, I feel it everywhere except in my legs. And you can put this on the floor, and then you can do your legs. Yes, you can. Yes, yes, yes. Feel it really strong in the back of the arm. Yeah. Yep, 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 yep. So guys, I pray that you were blessed today. I had promised some folks that I was going to do this video podcast on hypertension today. Make sure you go back and see osteoporosis. Yes. In any other of the health videos that we have out there, we have walking videos where we walk, guys. Some on smoothies and making various foods. And yes, they're there. And we do the spiritual Bible quizzes, helping us with our spiritual life, understanding what scriptures and what is going on. Yes, 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 making it by fun. So let's do this, guys. Let's become a family. And let's support each other. Yes, let's do this. 2024, we're moving forward, guys. We're moving forward. Yes, we are. And we're moving forward in good health. So I want to hear you guys say, I'm trying. I'm starting. Most people will say, I'm not doing it like you. You don't have to do it like me. You don't have to walk as long as I walk, or as fast as I walk, or turn this pedal as fast as I do. That's not the goal. That's not what it's about. It's just that you will do something to help better your health and help lower your blood pressure, help fight off that potential of heart disease. We're not going to be in that 40%. No, we're not there. We're not there. We're better than that. We're better than that. Yes, Grandma, we're better than that. You keep eating right and you keep exercising. Get that fruit and eat those bananas. Eat fruits and vegetables, guys. Let's do it. Let's do it. Yes. Watch the meat. Watch the fried food. Yeah. Watch the cold cuts. Watch the hot dogs. Watch that salt. Watch that salt. Watch that sugar. Let's do this. We can do this. Yes, we can. Yes, we can, and you not only, yes, we can, but we will with God's help. Yes. Yes. This is the encourager, guys. This is the encourager. Yeah, 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 yeah. Moving forward. Come on, all you melanated black people. We got this. Again, like I say, anybody can listen to this video, but sometimes we need to be specific. Because our community is very, you've already seen the percentage that I gave you. So we need to work on that. You can't say everybody can. Right now, our community need to work on ourselves. We need to build ourselves up. Take care of our health. Yes, we do. Mentally, spiritually, physically, and financially. You want to be around for your kids. You want to be around for your grandkids, your great-grands even. Yes, and you want to be there healthy and strong, Grandma, in your right mind. Yes. Yes, you do. Oh, my goodness. Yes. We're going to manage this thing. We got it. We got it. We got it. Woo. Feeling it, guys. I'm feeling it. and your girl is feeling it. I gotta check my heart rate. See where I am now. I am feeling it. On a treadmill yesterday, guys. You gotta check that one out. Listen, we're gonna see you right here next time. This is the Encourager, Queen C, No Longer Bound. Thank you for coming. Thank you. We appreciate you. We'll see you right here next time.